You're listening to MasbachRadio.com, uplifting music and encouraging messages. And today with me in the Masbach Radio studio is Apostle David Juma from Nairobi, Kenya. He's traveling all over the world to preach the gospel. And I am so excited for you to hear this today. Pastor, you said, Christy, I'm going to share with all of Masbach Radio's listeners the nuggets of the gospel.
Awesome. Nuggets of the gospel. Paul, the man of God, preached the gospel to the Gentiles. And he wrote the book of Romans, and I'm going to share with this with you, chapter number one of book of Romans, amazing scripture, and pick up some things very quickly. Verse one, Paul, a bond servant of Jesus Christ, called to be an apostle, separated to the gospel of God. The gospel of God, that phrase, I like it. Gospel of God, gospel is the good news, which verse 2 says, which he promised before through his holy prophets in the holy scriptures. Verse 3, concerning his son Jesus Christ, our Lord, who was born of the seed of David according to the flesh, and declared to be the Son of God with power according to the Spirit of holiness by the resurrection from the dead. Verse 5, through him we have received grace and apostleship for obedience to the faith among all nations for his name, among whom also are the called of Jesus Christ. Six verses, beautiful introduction about this gospel of God. And as I was studying scripture, just like every Christian must always be reading the word of God, listening to the Holy Spirit, I found very interesting things about this gospel of God, because the gospel is the good news. And six things we'll share, but very quickly, number one, it was promised before by his holy prophets in the scriptures. The good news we are handling as a Christian, you need to know that this word, this good message from God, has also been spoken about by those who went before us. And we cannot ignore our history. And we have history from the word of God showing how prophets like Isaiah, you know, one time we were praying for a couple who had no baby, and we were trusting God that the womb of this woman will be opened and she'll get a baby somewhere in Nairobi, Kenya, a couple of years ago. And as we were praying, the Holy Spirit showed me a vision. Isaiah 53 opened, the Bible was opened to me, and the voice of the Lord said, look what I've done for you through my son. How he was wounded for transgressions, and how, you know, he was chastised for peace, and how by his wounds we are healed, you know. And so the good news spoken by Isaiah and other prophets was such a powerful prophetic word spoken of how Jesus was to come, how he was to go to the cross. You remember, like David, Psalms 22 say, my father, why have you forsaken me? And you know, this is a cry of Jesus years later.
Yeah.
But David prophetically is crying this cry.
That's amazing.
It's amazing how the prophets went before us and spoke about Jesus, spoke about the Messiah. This is the answer to the world. And this encourages me, because what I'm dealing with as a man called by God to preach the good news of Christ and bring people to salvation, bring them to healing, bring them to hope, so that they can know there is hope. And you know how many people are sensing hopelessness in the world. But the good news is that Jesus Christ is still bringing hope and blessing to change and transform lives. And so this, number one, is a major nugget, that what we are handling was promised to us before by the prophets through the Holy Scriptures. And guess what? As a Christian, if you're feeling low and doubting your faith and little doubting God and your faith going down, you need to go back to Scripture. Go back to the Word of God. Read it. It's a nugget. It's going to help you to discover that this thing you're handling is very old. It's been there. Prophets spoke about it. And number two, it is concerning his son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. So this good news, gospel of God, is concerning the Son of God, Jesus Christ. You see, as a church, as God's people, if we lose the centrality of Christ in our life, in our practice, in our worship, in our giving, in our ministry, in our own family, then we'll lose a very important nugget, very important matter. Jesus Christ should be at the center of it all.
Definitely.
And so those of us who preach, guess what? We only preach one message. I like one preacher who said, if you're an evangelist, for instance, you don't need to look for a message. Wonder what I'm going to preach tomorrow. The message is there. Jesus Christ is the message.
Yes.
And so this gospel of God, the good news from God, is concerning who? Jesus Christ. We don't preach anything else. We don't preach ourselves. We don't preach some good philosophy. Look, there are many educated people that have good knowledge on many subjects, and there are many counselors, and there are many mentors, people in business, in science, in technology. I tell you the truth, there are many wonderful things that can help you. But guess what? The good news of God concerning Jesus Christ is the one that has ultimate power to change lives. You see, a motivator can tell you how to remain motivated, but motivation has no power to change lives. There's only one thing I know has the capacity to change people's lives, and this is the good news concerning Jesus Christ. How he came, he was given as a gift from God, and if you believe him, receive him in your heart, he will, you know, save you, set you free. The blood he shed on the cross, you know, is a remedy for sin. He washed your sins away, and you receive peace and hope and joy. So it's concerning Jesus.
Yes, it all centers back to that. Everything you need, everything you crave. And if right now you're listening to Maasbach Radio and you are in need of this answer, Jesus Christ, go over to maasbachradio.com, send in your prayer request, and we're going to pray for you in a few minutes here from Maasbach Radio Studio. Pastor Juma, we've come to the third nugget of the gospel.
Absolutely. From Romans chapter 1, verse 4. And this gospel, which was concerning Christ, we say number 2. Thirdly, and declared to be the Son of God with the power. I tell you, the good news has power. And anybody who is going to share the gospel must not only have experienced the power of God, but every time the good news is shared, in it is the power to change lives. I tell you, talk about the power of God and how it's transformed me and changed me. I tell you, I have testimonies and stories of the victory that I've acquired from the power of the gospel. In fact, Romans, if you read this chapter down, verse 16 says, Paul says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God to the Jews and the Greeks, you know, everyone who believes. And so this is a nugget. The gospel is not just mere words. You know, Paul says when he went to Thessalonica and he came to you, we did not come with word only, but also we came with the power of God. And this power of God, as we're going to be praying a little later, the power of God is going to heal you. The power of God is going to lift your heart and soul and your mind from depression and distress and heavy burdens. You know, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He's still doing those things he did before for all those who believe. And guess what? Mark 16 says, and these signs shall follow them that believe. You don't need to have known scripture a lot before. You don't need to have been a bishop, a pastor, a man of God. You know, you just need to be someone who is ready to believe. Wherever you are, if you believe, this nugget of the power of God in the good news shall become a reality to you and your family and your business and your life and your world.
Yes, amen. I believe that.
Awesome. And then the next one is that the gospel should be declared according to the spirit of holiness. You see, those who transact the good news must have been changed and transformed by the same good news, so that when they share out, their life and character depicts the change that has occurred in their lives. And so the spirit of holiness is part of their life. Because I tell you what, these are holy things. The word of God is holy. God whom we worship is holy. He says, be holy as I'm holy. So there's the nugget for those of us who not only benefit from the gospel, or handle the gospel, must handle this thing with the spirit of holiness. In other words, the fear of God is part of what we do. You know, we have dominion and power over sin. We live holy lives. We live as patterns. Paul tells Timothy, writing to the Philippians about Timothy, says, you know his manner of life, you know, and you know his proven character. And so we are trusting God that as you hear the good news, you will desire the transformation that comes through the gospel, so that your life can be pure and holy. And the Bible says in the Beatitudes, Matthew 5, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. So we must remember there's a nugget that the gospel must be handled according to the spirit of holiness. We've been given this grace and apostleship for obedience to the faith. Those who hear the gospel must obey it. And how do they obey it? In other words, must receive it by faith. Everything we are saying about God is received by faith. And faith comes by hearing. So those of you who are tuned in and you're hearing this wonderful word, I believe your faith is rising up. And guess what? As your faith rises up, you're positioning yourself for a miracle, for Amen. Change, for transformation. You receive answers to prayer. You know, your life will have a future and a hope. And the young generation especially, you know, probably have lost hope and don't know how tomorrow holds like. Gospel of God, if you believe it, it will change you and transform you and give you a future and a hope. So all those who hear the gospel, the transacting currency is called faith. And by it we shall live. In fact, when he said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel, because there's a power of God, Romans 1:16, verse 17 says, for in it, the gospel, the righteousness of God, you know, is revealed, you know, from faith to faith. And then says, for the just shall live by faith. And so those of us who hear the good news and are changed and transformed and born again, then we live thereafter by faith. And our obedience by faith makes the good news of God a reality. And finally, the gospel is for all nations. You know, among all nations for his name, this is Romans 1 verse 5. You know, every nation here in Netherlands, back in Kenya where I come from, Africa, Asia, all nations where the good news of Christ is proclaimed and people believe. And when they believe, they are willing to walk by faith. This gospel is also good news for them. And here in Europe, we believe God in this year and the years to come, there will rise another generation that is carrying the fire, the power of the word of God. And they can tell Europe that Europe, you shall be saved.
Yes, amen.
Even Netherlands shall be saved.
That's awesome. We've been talking about the nuggets of the gospel. We've been talking about faith that precedes the miracle. We've been talking about the power of the gospel. So I would suggest if you need a miracle for yourself or a loved one, then get ready and let your faith be built up on Maasbach Radio as we get ready to pray with Apostle David Juma on the Blessing Family Music Station.
Maasbach Radio.
You've heard the word of God, the good news, the gospel of God. What is the good news? That Jesus died for you, shed his blood, rose again on the third day. Today he's alive to supervise your salvation, your healing, and your miracle. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus, the name that is given above every name, the name above witchcraft, the name above sorcery, the name above all darkness, the name above every disease, is the name above the devil himself. For all dominion, authorities, or powers are under Christ. I pray in the name of Jesus, every listener that is sick, be healed right now. From the top of your head to the soles of your feet, I decree healing in Jesus' name. And I command every bacteria and every virus to wither and die in the name of Jesus. Father, I ask you, release the power of healing right now upon every listener. And God, I pray for the young people that are lost hope, or that mother that has lost hope, or that father that is disillusioned, doesn't know what to do. I pray that the blessing of the Lord, the Spirit of the living God, shall touch them right now. Lord, I give you praise for the things that you are doing right now. For Jesus Christ, you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. Somebody receive your miracle now. Receive forgiveness of sins. Receive salvation. Receive healing in Jesus' name. Receive hope. Receive joy again. Receive deliverance. In the name of Jesus, I pray, Lord, do amazing things everywhere. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.